society was that we already knew that we were doing 25 plus years in law enforcement. That was us, right? That was what we were striving for. That was what we were working for. And that is what our mental capacity was, right? So as I talked to this manager, one of the things that I explained to her was the new generation does not feel the same way. They have no intention whatsoever to put 30 years into a career, right? 30 years into working for the same person and doing the same thing for 30 years. They have no intention on doing that, right? The mold has changed. The shape of our generations have changed. I think that's a good thing, right? I think that's a good thing because if you're not willing to do 30 years of doing the same thing for someone else, then that means that you are going to force yourself to reinvent yourself. And if you force yourself to reinvent yourself, then guess what, right? There's nothing easy about reinventing yourself. And so you may be soft and mushy right now, but try reinventing yourself six times, right? Six times over every 6 years, from your 20s all the way up to your 50s, right? You will become a very, very adaptable and a very, very resilient person. So you may not be that way right now, but don't shame yourself and don't knock yourself for not being that person because you haven't planted the seeds yet. You haven't become that person yet. Right now, you're an individual with no resolve. And a lot of people are telling you that you're an individual, okay, who has no stick-to-itiveness. You're an individual who has no, you can't stay with one thing. And I'm telling you that some people are good at staying with one thing and some people are not. So, however, the person that you are, guys, be that person fully, but you have to plant the seed now, today, right now. You have to plant the seed in order to have the harvest in the future. And that goes for any type of person you are. If you're the person that can do 25 years, plant that seed right now. Plant that seed right now and plan for an aggressive increase, okay, in your level of responsibility in your job, in your position, or whatever you're doing, right? And that level of responsibility means more work, taking on more work, giving more value, giving more yourself, and you continually do that over and over again until you get to the point of where, okay, people are coming to you and asking you what should they do next, right? You become that person, but those seeds have to be planted, right? Those seeds have to be planted. Now, one of the most important things that I tell people when it comes to reshaping, rethinking and reevaluating their life is health. Man, health is near and dear to me, guys. I've been a personal trainer over 30 years. I was a personal trainer. I was a drill sergeant at the police academy. I taught nutrition plans. I have a degree from Rutgers University, and doing all of this, one of the most important things I think to me is helping other people to tackle health issues, other people to tackle nutrition issues, other people to tackle being as functional as possible for as long as possible. Because I believe that that's my goal in life, right? My goal in life is to be a functional individual for as long as I could possibly be a functional individual. I'm killing, sorry about that, Akita. Functional individual, right? And I think that if you become a functional individual for a long period of time, right? And you develop the habit of that's who you are, what usually happens is you want to help other people to achieve that as well. And I think that's important, right? I think that is so key. I think that is so important. I think that is so valuable. Because one of the things that we can't get back, out of the two most important things to me, right? One thing is time. You can never get back time once it is spent. Once time is gone, it is gone, guys. And there's no getting back any second of time that you waste on whimsical BS. Period. You can't get it back. It is gone forever, right? The next thing, guys, is your health. Once you let your health go, okay, trying to reverse it is like climbing Mount Everest, right? Okay, and getting it back is literally impossible. Guys, I've watched people who don't understand that health is a long game. A very long game if you're lucky. You know, my father at age 87, right? I can remember he's about 77 years old before he even turned his 80s. You know, I had just lost my mom. And he asked me, what was I going to do with the second half of my life? Right? I was about 48 years old, coming up on my 50s. And so that submerged me, right, into a deep realm of thinking that I had never been before. What was I going to do with the second half of my life? I felt that I had mastered the first half of my life of being in law enforcement, right? Being in law enforcement, in retrospect, I look back at it and I go, okay, yes, I was good at my career. I had skills, right? I had skills, but I hadn't mastered it. I hadn't mastered the first half of my life. I was still making tons of mistakes, guys. I was still making tons of mistakes in the first half of my life. So, what was I going to do with the second half of my life? How was I going to, right, do some of the things that I had no balls to do the first half of my life, right? Right? I had no guts to do the first half of my life. Well, one of the first things I told myself I was going to do was write a book. Write a book. And I wrote a book. Top 25 Mistakes in Route to the Good Life. I wrote it. Right? I wrote it and I'm excited about it. And it's a good book too. On top of that, it is a good book. The second most important thing that I said I was going to do was give value. Give value to as many people as possible. Now, I really didn't know how I was going to give value to as many people as possible. My goal is 1 million people, right? So, as I worked toward giving a value to 1 million people, one of the things that I needed to learn was, how do I reach 1 million people? What do I do, right? What do I do? So, I began doing my YouTube videos every day. I began doing my top 25 mistakes started off with the top 100 mistakes in Route to the Good Life. So I was doing videos on YouTube, and my videos transitioned to a top 25 mistakes book, and my mentor manifesto, and so tons of other things that I decided to move on to give value. But probably the most important thing that I needed to learn, which I really didn't realize that I needed to learn, was marketing to people who wanted to hear my message. I couldn't figure out how to do it. I didn't know what to do. And it's all because, right, I hadn't planted those seeds yet. I hadn't planted those seeds because that was a package of seeds that I didn't even know that I needed, right? And it is so, so deep that I tell you guys this, is that you don't know what you don't know until you're in a situation where you need, right, what you need, right? And I don't know if that makes any sense to you guys, man, but as I put it out there, I'll say it once again. You don't know what you don't know until you're in a situation that you realize that you need what you don't know you need. Okay? So